The Peregrine Falcon, my wife just walked in, she wants to get a little video as well. But what the major differences are, the Peregrine Falcon, look at the head. Now, if you remember the Prairie Falcon's head was much lighter in color, and it had a mustache, just a little stripe coming down below the eye. And the Peregrine has a mustache, but it's much, much heavier, and the mustache actually kind of covers the whole head. They both have the beautiful black eyes. They both have the long, pointy wings. They both have the long, long, slender toes and the shorter tails. And both of them are a very similar size. The Peregrine is slightly larger, but they're very similar in size to each other. And they like different kinds of habitats. Where the Peregrine Falcon loves thousand-foot cliffs. They love places like Zion's and the Grand Canyon and those kinds of places. It's okay, sweetie. And the Prairie Falcon likes the open desert. They like the lower mesas. And so they're both cliff nesters. Here she comes. Oh, good girl. That's a nice rouse. And this little gal has got a bit of an issue. She comes out of a captive breeding program. She's not from the wild. An individual that breeds these to make them available for falconry and has for a number of years. This little gal ended up with some problems in the nest. And we'll kind of show you. The first problem that she has is her vision is really bad. She's not blind. She can see, but the vision is very, very limited, especially on her right side. You can see here, she's following me with her left eye, but her right eye has very, very poor vision. And even her, that's my girl, has very, very poor vision. And so she would never be able to survive in the wild with that really, really poor vision. She has kind of a strange, let me get her on a glove so I can show you a little better. Hey, sweetie. There's my pretty girl. Now, please understand, we just got her, so she's not used to me yet. Oh, there's my pretty girl. What a good girl. She's not used to me. Even though she came out of a breeding project, these are still considered wild animals. What a pretty lady. Yes, you are. Hey, baby, such a pretty girl. So anyway, I want you to look at her foot over here. I don't know how well you can see that, but look at this toe. You can see that the nail is bent up in a weird direction. And so that's genetic. There's some kind of a problem with that. And we're going to do some trimming and see if we can get the nail to go the right direction. But that'll take some time. The vision, I don't think will ever be corrected on her. I don't think we can. She will always have limited vision, but she has some, but she'll always have limited vision. And so she'll never be able to go into the wild. She'll never be able to fly free. The person that had her, the breeder, basically said at about 20 feet away, she virtually couldn't identify him. She couldn't see him very well. And so that's a little bit of an issue. In most cases, like I said, they can't go back to the wild. If she were in a nest in the wild, she would have died. But because she was in a captive breeding program, and because the breeder just needed to find a home for her, he contacted us and asked if we could possibly take her, that she needs a good home to live out the rest of her life, and have her as a wildlife ambassador to educate the public about wildlife, and in this case about the Peregrine Falcon. And so if all goes well, this beautiful young lady will be a friend of ours at the foundation for a good 20 years plus, if everything goes well. And she's right here. This is our little Peregrine, which is a Peregrine Falcon. And she's doing very, very well, aren't you, sweetie? You're being such a good girl. Such a pretty girl.
Yes, you are. You're being such a pretty girl.
That's my lady.
Such a pretty lady. Okay. Such a pretty girl.
Now, if you notice, I don't have a hood for her.
And I have hoods that will fit her, but I don't have a hood for her for the simple reason she's terribly, terribly nearsighted. And so she doesn't see things very well. And this is why we have her as a wildlife ambassador, because of her disability. And I have to be very careful with her and handle her a little bit differently because of her vision problems. But even though she can't fly, she can't be a falcon bird, she can't be put back in the wild, she will never ever for her entire life be able to go to soar thousands of feet in the sky and dive at 200 miles an hour like a normal peregrine because of her vision. But she's going to live a very, very long, a very happy life as a wildlife ambassador, educating the public about what peregrines are. And so the sad thing, she won't be able to fly and hunt like a peregrine, but the good thing is that she's not going to be subject to all of the dangers of being out in the wild, so she will actually have a much longer, healthier, and more comfortable life. And come on, this little gal, because she's our newest one, she gets to come upstairs and hang out in the living room with us and watch TV because we are acclimating her to all of the activities within her environment. And so the TV and transporting the vehicles and everything and a silly dog that likes to run around and race are all things that she has to be used to. And she's doing a terrific job, as you can see. Huh, Dum-Dum?
Such a pretty girl. Such a pretty little girl, yes you are.
And so if all goes well, we're gonna go through all of the names that people have submitted to us for our Name the Falcon contest. And I think this weekend we'll see if we can come up with a good name for her.
Such a pretty girl. Yes, you are, you're such a pretty girl. And you do like hanging out with the family, don't you, sweetie? Okay, here we go.
Now what I'm putting her on here, this is called a screen perch, because it's got kind of a screen right here, so she does kind of fall off, she can climb back up and get back on the perch. And so this is the safest thing we can have her on. And again, her vision's got a real issue here.
Huh, baby? Your vision's terrible. I have to be a seeing eye person for a falcon, don't I? Oh, there you go. Here's my pretty girl. Oh, it's okay. It's okay, sweetie. That's my pretty girl. Yes, you are.
So anyway, we got the kids in the house for the evening now, and again, thank you so very, very much for all of the mice. We greatly appreciate that, and we'll talk to everybody soon.
Delhead, you're not that hungry, are you? He's not that quite that hungry, are you? Thank you. You don't like that part. Forget it. You're a picky little eater. But a messy one.
She's gonna throw guts all over you.
Yep. That just means she's not terribly hungry.
She's a pretty girl.
Yeah, it's really sad that her vision's so bad. Nice to get her to have her flying, but she'll never be allowed to fly because she can't see well enough to fly.
You can go to Roten Pro and you can order these gift certificates for us. And so the next time we're low on food, we can just use the gift certificates and order the food for the animals that we need. And everybody else out there, thank you for all of the kindness that you've shown us. You guys are incredible. Thank you so much.
And we'll come back and get you in just a minute. Oh, I know, Belle. I'm talking to somebody else. I'll get you in a second, sweetie. I promise. We'll get a little more involved with our newest little friend. She's a young peregrine falcon, and I'll tell you her story, but let me get impatient Belle, who just thinks that she's the queen and she should have all of the attention. Huh, sweetie? Yes, you should. You should have all of the attention. Nobody should get any more attention than you, because you're the queen of the foundation. You're our girl.